afternoon, students. Today we are going to be talking about interview skills, which are very significant for us to be understood as we prepare constantly in different phases of our life to sit and appear for interviews. So let's begin in this session that what is it that we can learn more about interview skills. We realize that interview is nothing but conversation between interviewer and interviewee. We also understand that this information is precisely, this interview is conducted precisely to obtain information about the interviewee. So interview also involves face-to-face interaction. When we talk about face-to-face interaction, this helps people in employee selection. It could also be a process which could be used for placement, for orientation, for appraisal, for discipline action, exit or separation, opinion or views to be known by the employee, you know, for ideas and suggestions, feelings or fears, hopes that one has, and ambitions that one has towards the career. So these are certain aspects which are revealed during an interview. When we talk about interview, it also happens to reveal the views and ideas and attitudes of the person who is being interviewed, as well as the skills of the interviewer. Now when we talk about interviews, we also have to understand that it requires certain amount of preparation. It requires certain amount of experience for everyone to perform better. The employment interview specifically needs a good deal of preparation by both the interviewer and the candidate who is being interviewed. Let's look at how many types of interviews do we have. We have 7 types of interviews which will be discussed in today's session. Firstly, as you see, promotion interviews, appraisal interviews, exit interviews, problem interviews, stress interview, reprimand interview, employment or selection interview. Let's look at the first kind of the interview, which is promotion interviews. When I mention promotion interview, this is particularly an interview which is scheduled wherein there is no competition per se. The interview is likely to be informal and serves as an induction into a new team, into new responsibilities that you will have within the same organization for which you have been working earlier. There is clarification given to you with regard to duties and the responsibilities and the expectations that are there from the candidate with regard to the promotion that you're going to be receiving. The promotion interview is conducted for an employee who is already working in an association, is already in an organization and is looking towards the higher job opportunity or the position within that same company. So this promotion interview is inevitably, as you seek career advancement, it is most likely to happen then. It also helps you discuss opportunities in your career. What kind of advancement do you expect within the organization? The next kind of interview is appraisal or assessment interview. When we talk of appraisal interview, it is a formal discussion, a process between the employee and his or her manager. We understand that this kind of a method requires competition, but to a certain extent between the other employees that you have. It also refers to self-assessment. In most cases, in organizations, you are given an appraisal form where you fill it up on the basis of how your performance has been in the last year, and then that self-assessment form is assessed or supervised by your supervisor or the senior, and on the basis of that you are given opportunity for promotion. So these kind of interviews are held yearly in an organization. You also have periodic assessments. It focuses on the career development and shortcomings that one has. So because of in the appraisal form, you have various categories on which your performance of the last year is assessed. You understand that these how far you have been able to develop your personality in order to become a better professional within the work environment. If there are any shortcomings, those are also mentioned or discussed in this kind of an interview. Such interviews help you to be increasing productivity within an organization. It also helps you change the work habits for good. As we move forward, we understand that there are certain points to be understood while appraisal interview is to be conducted and for it to be successful. We have to understand that the organizer of this interview or the interviewee must make sure that you have friendly attitude. There should be the manager should allay the fears of the employee with having an attitude wherein he doesn't sound very rude or is most likely to provide an environment where the person interviewee is made comfortable. You should firstly talk about the plus points of the employee's performance and compliment him or her. This will help you in motivating the employee. The shortcomings can be pointed out very calmly and in an objective manner a little later. Criticism should be followed by positive suggestions. As we move further, we realize that employee should also be allowed to present his side, his problems, his suggestions in this kind of an atmosphere which is built up by the interviewee. Now, the manager should also try to understand the problems and offer help here in this case. It is in this time that your future targets can be very clearly mentioned to the person. What do you expect? What kind of a performance do you expect from the individual? Now then, the other kind of interview that we have, the third kind, is called exit interview. In an exit interview, this is a conversation between departing employee and the representative of the organization, who could be an HR or head of the employee within that organization. The exit interview is given to an employee who has resigned already, is scheduled for somebody like that, and it accomplishes certain points, certain factors in an interview. The organization can benefit a lot by organizing exit interviews for themselves, as in this kind of a formal interview, you can easily find out the precise reason for employee. Why is it that employee 1 has taken this decision of leaving the organization? Then it is better for the organization's public image as well. If in case you can sort out the problems or resolve the queries and help the person exit with a positive image of the organization, it will do good, a lot of good to your public image. It helps you also maintain good relations with the past employees. Then it is also, this kind of interview acts as an asset to the organization, because the organization can then eventually take up a lot of steps which will help them improve. Now, there are certain things to be accomplished when you are organizing such interviews. So like I had mentioned previously, you have to understand the reason for why the employee has taken this decision to leave the organization. If there is any misunderstanding or if there is any ill feeling, this is the opportunity where you can clear it. It is better for the organization's public image and to maintain better relations with the past employees as well. You can also get feedback on the employees' attitudes and the opinion towards organization policies. You understand that if in case there is some kind of a fear, because employee who is leaving will not have any fear. So it is easy for you to understand the organization employee relations that are there, public relations, the sales policies, or various other considerations or the problems that could be there within an organization at the structural level, and which could possibly be the reason for the person leaving the job. Now, when we talk about exit interview, it should also entail that you discuss the final paycheck. That is there, information about when this final paycheck will be ready, how it will be handed over to the individual. It will also talk about giving information about accrued benefits. For example, you have sick leave, on leaves, how many of them have been used by the employee. If in case there are certain calculations, please make those calculations. I'm sure the other individual on the other side must have also made these calculation. So by giving these information about the provident fund, about group insurance or other benefits that your company has been providing to the employee, It'll be better for the image that you have. It will be better for you to provide that kind of an information in this exit interview. You must also be able to check whether all the books, manuals, tools, equipment that have been issued to the employee have been returned by him or not before leaving. Then the next kind of interview is problem interview. In the problem interview, it is a meeting with a problem employee. There are certain times when you have issues with the performance or the behavior which is unsatisfactory of a particular individual in your work organization. So this kind of an interview is most likely to suggest that there could be a solution to the problem, and instead of giving directly warnings and notices, it's best to resolve them at this stage. So the reason for the employee's poor performance can be found out in this face-to-face interaction. It could be any problem of any nature, various nature. For example, it could be a domestic problem. You couldn't find out the reason until unless you sit down with the individual and take up this kind of schedule or this kind of an interview. It could also be ill health, lack of training or dissatisfaction with the job. It could be failure to adjust in this kind of new work environment. Many organizations have facilities for counseling as well for the staff. So this interview will help you schedule a session with the counselor, and if employee's behavior is still unsatisfactory, the interview can be looked at. It can be an area to give a clear understanding of what is expected out of that individual and what shall be the consequences of unacceptable conduct. As we look forward, we realize that there is another kind of interview called stress interview, and the term itself very clearly tells us that the individual here is deliberately placed in stressful situations to observe how the candidate reacts during the job interview or in various situations to be handled within an organization. So we realize that this is a method which is used for selection for positions in which person must be able to face difficult situations, and he shouldn't be getting upset. The stress interview also checks you for qualities such as courage, tact, cool temper and self-command, which are much needed when you are confronted by employees or people in big or small groups. Then there are several methods that could be used to make sure that the candidate loses the balance, and you could use various techniques for it. So for taking these kind of interviews also, both the interviewer and interviewee require a lot of practice and training. Let's look at what are the methods we can use or what we have to prepare ourselves for when we are supposed to be expecting stress interview. In such situation, you should expect rapid fire questions. The questions can also be asked by different members of the panel together. So how do you respond to that? Cross questioning could be there, arguments could be there. The panel member could be disputing the candidate's statement. They could be rejecting these statements altogether. They could be ridiculing your answer that you've been given as per your opinion that is there. You can also expect that you might be subjected to silence or inattention given by the panel members who are interviewing you. And you find that interviewer specifically adopts hostile behavior towards you. So what happens is the candidate must be, towards the end of such an interview, informed about it that this was a stress interview. Even if in case it does not happen, you should keep calm. What you're tested for is how can you handle various situations within an organization. Then there is something, the next kind of interview is reprimand interview. Now in this kind of an interview, we have basically various warnings that have been given to an individual in an organizational structure where something that has been done or something that should not have been done has happened, and this is actually a part of the disciplinary procedure of the organization to take up the corrective measures. Now in such an interview, we understand that this is an interview which is a formal nature. This kind of an interview helps you improve the work performance. to prevent the recurrence of such offenses that could lead to a lot of problem within the organization, as one person's behavior will also influence other members of the organization to behave in a particular manner. So that can be curtailed. Wrong practices could be curtailed here. Now, when we talk about the preparation to be required for reprimand interview, we must make sure that you have all the relevant documents and facts with you, wherein you are able to discuss very, very briefly what the problem is, and you take your time to investigate the matter fully beforehand. The employee who is called for the interview, we must make sure that he is called only after you have done your homework at the back end. And it shouldn't look like it's an arbitrary interview that has been conducted. You should keep in mind that the kind of person you're going to be dealing with, you should plan that as well. You should know what kind of arguments will be required, what kind of a temperament will be required in terms of what words should you choose in order to put across your point in a way which shouldn't be rude to the individual. Now, another important thing is that you should not deviate from your plan that you have. You should not reprimand in public as well. You should make sure that you ensure full privacy during the interview that is conducted. Now, during the interview as well as you're conducting reprimand interview, there are certain steps to be followed, certain checkpoints. So you have to straightly go to the point that you have to discuss. You have to be very precise and exact about the offense that you are discussing. Don't lose control over yourself. Stay calm as much as possible. Don't raise your voice. Don't enter into unnecessary arguments as well with the employer. Allow the employee to present his case as well. It shouldn't be one-sided interview. However, we must also make sure that we are not accepting justifications or excuses given by the individual. This can also require that you should also be, towards the end of it, make it clear that the purpose of reprimand interview is not to disgrace the employee. It is rather to help him improve, right? So with all of these things that you have, you will be able to conduct a better outcome of this kind of an interview will be there, but the performance, the focus will be on the improvement of the performance. Now, when we talk about employee selection interview, this is the most common interview pattern that you must have seen. When we talk about this kind of an interview, we talk about accessibility to assess the suitability of the candidate for a specific job. The interview is done on the basis of important decision. This kind of a decision is important not only for the employer but also for the candidate. The interviewer has to decide whether the candidate should be appointed in an organization, and he wants to find out how much will the presence of this candidate affect the organization, both in positive and if in case it is negative, you will not be invited into an organization. And at the same time, the choice of the organization that you're going to join will also affect your career growth, will influence your choices drastically. So, it is usually taken by the panel of the interviewers, taken in an office in an organization. But sometimes you find that there are campus interviews which can be conducted in particular institutions or colleges that you have. It ranges from 10 to 45 minutes. Sometimes it can go longer as well, wherein you can have several steps from written test to a formal interview that is being conducted. But there is a structure that this employment selection interview follows. Let's have a look at that selection structure. You will firstly have your application verification. At this stage, your CV and your cover letter are very important to make an impact. Then you will have interview round. Then your skills will be evaluated during this process. Then applicant rating is done, wherein your previous details will also be verified. Whatever you've written, is it correct or not? So employment verification is also done at this stage. After that, skills profile is looked at finally to lead to the decision that whether the person will be selected, whether the person will be getting the job, or there'll be no hiring, or agency workforce candidate can be hired, right? So it is a yes or no that will be given to you at that stage. On this note, I would like to tell you that we must keep in mind that there are various aspects of job interview, and in this session, as we have learned how many types of interviews are there, we shall be able to focus on preparation of interview as well. So let's look forward to the next video lecture, video session, wherein we will be discussing certain ways and certain methods that will help us prepare better for the interviews that we will be taking. Thank you.